Hello everyone, welcome to Dress My Craft. This is design team member Jayshree this side. Today I will be sharing a small review of the cute little die cut machine Easy Cuts from Dress My Craft, along with a tutorial on how to use die cuts in various ways. Before we get started, do subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to stay updated with our latest videos. So here it is, the very cute and amazing Easy Cuts die cutting and embossing machine. In the box, we get an instruction manual, two transparent acrylic cutting plates, and of course the machine. Look at how cute and sturdy it is at the same time. Now, if we talk about the packaging box, it comes with a plastic handle, making it easy to carry. The box also outlines clearly the contents inside the box, how to make a die cutting sandwich, along with the kind of materials you can use to die cut with the machine. Now, talking about the machine itself, it is very light in weight, so much so that it can be lifted with just one finger. It has anti-slippery rubbers at the bottom of the machine as well as on the sides of the fold-away platforms, which makes it stay in its place no matter what the surface. It prevents the machine from moving while die cutting or embossing. Next, talking about the platform of the machine, it is built in such a manner that your acrylic plates don't fall off it. Now, if we see the rollers of the machine, they are very strong and smooth, so much so that the plates pass through even without a die and cutting material between them. Finally, here is the instruction manual that comes with the machine, which clearly instructs you on how to use the machine, how to use the cutting pads, which materials you can use to die cut and emboss, how to make different cutting and embossing sandwiches, and lastly, how to clean and maintain your machine. Of this machine, let's see how well it cuts using different materials. To start with, I have here a 120 GSM soft floral oriental paper from Dress My Craft, and I will cut foliage from foliage and leaves die set number 8. To make my sandwich, I am placing one of my acrylic plate first, then my paper, then my cutting die upside down, and finally the second acrylic plate on top. Now, I am moving the sandwich through the rollers with the help of the handle on the side. And voila! Our foliage is cut in one swift roll itself. Next, I am cutting using a 250 GSM cardstock with a tropical swirl die from Dress My Craft. I am making the same sandwich as before and going to and fro for this die as it is a little intricate. And look at that, what a superb clean crisp cut. I am using the ultimate die cleaning tool from Dress My Craft to clean the die and take the die cut out of it. Now let's try an even heavier cardstock, which is 300 GSM, and use the biggest petal from the Peony Petals die set. Making the same sandwich and moving it to and fro to make sure it cuts properly. Here, look at how crisp the cut of this heavy cardstock is. And I hope you are able to see that very fine embossed line on the edge of the petal. Okay, so let's see if this machine can cut the faux leather paper as well. I am placing the very intricate classic doily die onto the faux leather paper, and I am moving it in the machine a couple of times just to make sure it cuts properly. I am cleaning the die with the ultimate die cleaning tool, and wow, look at that, such a beautiful die cut it is. Now let's try cutting a glitter foam sheet with the crochet border die as well. Thank you. got again a perfect die cut. Lastly, let's try to cut a heavy base vellum sheet using a 5-petal die. And yet again, a perfect cut. In my opinion, this machine stands true to its name, Easy Cuts. It definitely cuts easily and almost every cardstock you want. Now let's make a card using the die cuts from Easy Cuts. I am beginning by taking two pieces of 120 GSM paper and smooshing some distress oxide inks on my non-stick craft mat. I am spraying some water on the inks to activate the color and putting the paper on it to pick up the colors. I am heat setting the colors using the heat tool. I am repeating the same on the other piece of paper as well. Using the foliage die from the Hugs and Kisses die set, I am going to die cut the two pieces of paper. I am also die cutting Hugs and Kisses sentiment using a black 180 GSM cardstock 3 times. Stacking all the 3 die cuts of the sentiment on top of each other to give it dimension. After adhering all the die cuts in their places on the note card, I am adding splatters of the same distress oxide ink on the card. Finally, I am adhering this note card onto the card base, and here our very own clean and simple card using die cuts is ready in no time. Moving on, let's see how to make a pretty flower using some leftover paper strips from the Pink Smoke pattern paper pack. I'm using the petals from the curved flower die set. As you can see, the platform is long enough to hold at least 3 large petals at once for die cutting. Once I have die cut all the petals required, I am placing them on a paper towel and spraying some water on them to make the paper a little soggy and easy to mold. Now I am inking the edges of the petals using distress oxide in the color Worn Lipstick. Next, using the Groove Golf tool in the size medium, I am placing the die cut petals upside down on the foam pad and shaping the petals by pressing the Groove Golf tool on it and moving it inwards to the center. I am going to repeat the same on all the petals for shaping them. Next, turning the petals upright, I am pressing them in the middle using the ball tool in the size small from Dress My Craft. Next, to make the flower, I am stacking them on top of each other in descending order, a little off center. Lastly, adding the flower pearls in the color black in the center. Here, our flower is ready. For the last one, I thought of using the classic doily die cut we made from the faux leather paper and make an embellishment out of it. For this, I am using a piece of pattern paper from Vintage Saga paper pack and punching a banner using the banner punch from Dress My Craft. I am punching on both ends and cutting from the center to get 2 banners. I'm adhering these two banners on the doily with some 3D foam tape along with a fussy cutout flower, leaves and a sentiment from pink smoke motif sheet. And here our doily embellishment is ready in no time. If you wish to see how to use this doily embellishment onto a card, I will link the video for you on the top right corner. I hope you enjoyed making these simple and quick projects using die cuts from the cute little Easy Cuts machine and are all set to buy your own machine. The list of all the products used in this video are given in the description box below, so do check that out. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel before you go and hit the bell icon to stay updated with our latest videos. Until next time, happy crafting! Bye-bye!